traveling with students. People are good, safe and sound. So we have already about to complete this chapter. Inshallah, in next 2 to 3 lectures we are going to complete this chapter. And I must tell you students that this is a new syllabus, students, which has been revised last to last year. And this year 12 standard students has been revised. So students, you must have to learn all the technical terms. Okay, and these things cannot be learned in a hurry. You have to learn it slowly and gradually, because technical terms, you know, you have to understand that what does it mean to apply it technically. So students, please watch the lectures. Watch each and every lecture of IT. This we are learning the basics of information technology. This is very basic. In this you are just learning the different terms and what is the information technology, how it forms. Getting students? So I must tell you that you have to learn this terms which is related to technology, and all the terms are going to be used for future references also. If you know this very well, you are able to understand things technically as well. And nowadays students, you know that the world is becoming digital day by day. Everything is going to be digital, and slowly we are just coming towards the being a digital, we can say we are going to live in the digital world. So you have to learn this, students. And this is not the thing that you are going to learn in a day or two or in few days. Slowly and gradually you have to learn these things. So, and you know that this is an objective subject, student. Mostly objective questions are there. So here you have to be very particular with your answers. Getting, students? So what I want to say, students, that please watch each and every lecture. And this is objective, means you have to learn the terms very thoroughly, because you are not supposed to put any term anywhere. So you have to learn the relevant terms and you have to use it. Getting, students? So we were on the IT enabled services, popular IT enabled services. And students, you have got a very good option of OLE Learn, students. In OLE Learn, there are n number of questions are there. If you just keep on practicing those question papers, na, easily you will have, you know, a very, means a hold on all the terms. Because there are so many questions, one question can be of multiple questions. Getting, students, means it is getting repeated in some or the other form. So if you just practice that only, na, it will be enough for you, inshallah. Because there are hundreds of question papers, and if you just try to do it, you will definitely have the hold on the terms, and you can easily crack this objective chapters. Because you know, students, last year only, this year in 2019-21, student has scored 100 on 100 because of that OLE question papers only. Because every time you are just practicing it, but before that you have to see the lectures as well. Okay, because without understanding the lecture, you cannot practice that papers. You cannot attempt those papers, because if you attempt, it's useless, because you are not aware of any terms. So first you have to attempt, you have to learn to those terms which is there in your chapters, and then you are going to attempt it. So students, please just go through the chapters thoroughly, because each and every IT teachers, they are giving their best to make you understand. So you also, it's your duty also that if you're not having a college, at least you should watch the video lectures. Okay, so we are on the popular IT services, IT enabled services. Yes, students, what we have already completed 4 services, that is the call center, sorry, 2 services, call center, electronic publishing. Now we are going to start with the medical transcription and the data center, that is the 3rd and 4th one. Okay, so we have already completed which one, students? The call center Second one is your electronic publishing. And whichever terms you're learning here, students, you know, these single terms, they are having, you know, lots of jobs and so many options for you. If you just understand the very single term also, like call center, there are thousands and lakhs of different jobs in call center also. You must have to know that how it works. Electronic publishing, that is e-publishing, which we have already studied. Now the third, IT-enabled service, that means which gives the job opportunity, is the medical transcription. Transcription is what, students? The meaning of transcription is what? That from the voice messages or the voice notes, a person has to type it. It has to translate it into text. That is the transcription. From voice to text. Getting it, students, what I'm saying, transcription? Transcription means what, students? Voice to text. This is transcription. Now, here, what happens, students? Now, there are medical practitioners, or we can say the physicians, general physicians, MDs, doctors. They are having so many patients at a time. So generally what happens, that doctor is not having time to note down each and everything. So what he just says, tells, and whoever is the person standing beside the doctor or the physician, he just note down everything. And then what he does, he translates that, his voice, his or her voice, whatever transcription is there, into text, so that he can make a report of that particular patient's disease history. Getting, students? Now here, for example, there are so many doctors which are diagnosing with certain disease in a person, in a patient. And what they do, they just send the message to the, we can say the doctors which are more higher in degree, which are more experienced, to some other country like US. Okay, and then what the doctors, they just get all the, whatever the voice notes are there, the transcription is what they do, they translate it and they give the history to the particular doctor. And in return, that doctor sends the particular treatment that they have to start with, so and so medicine, so and so treatment, and then the further proceeding with the treatment will proceed in this way. So here, medical transcription was what, students? It is an allied health profession dealing with the process of transcribing voice recorded medical reports that are dictated by physicians, nurses and other healthcare practitioners. So here, what medical reports can be voice files, notes taken during a lecture or other spoken material. Medical transcription's task is very important, students, because they have to note down everything, whatever the doctor is speaking, from those spoken words. The transcription is what, they just have to translate it into text and they have to make a report of that particular patient. That, okay, so and so patient is having so and so medical history, whatever is the treatment was going on earlier, where he is staying, means whatever, a minor details, they have to transcribe it from voice to text and they have to make a report and then they have to present it to the doctor and to the patient as well. Okay, so here, students, the medical transcription task is very important. They have to be very particular with everything, that they should not make a mistake. That, so here, what the things, the voice notes also transferred from one country to another country to different doctors, and according to that, the reports are being made of the particular patient, that which treatment is going to be proceeded further. Okay, we'll just see one example, if you can see. Yeah. I'll just write medical transcriptionist. I'll just see. Look, in this way the medical report is being made. This is the medical report. Now what this person is doing, the transcriptionist is doing, what the patient name, date of admission, date of birth, what a gender, address, phone number, everything. What she is feeding in the computer, in the database, so that it can be made in a text form, so that the doctors can have the access, or the patient can have the access to his or her medical report. This is the whatever the doctor is speaking. Because many times the doctors, they are not having time to write the prescription or to write the things by their own because of the lots of patient and a very short duration. Okay, so that's why nowadays doctors are just having the appointment. They just tell the patients that they have to first take the appointment and then they have to come because they are not having time. So here the transcription, they are just what? Converting all the spoken words, okay? They are converting. Okay, just see here. I'll just show you one example. Look. See this. This is the allergy immunology. This is the sample report. See this student, this is a sample report of medical transcriptions. Like asthma in a 5-year-old. Description is mother states he has been wheezing and coughing. Okay, so this is the medical transcription report. Chief complaint is what? 5-year-old male presents to children's hospital emergency department by mother with have asthma. Okay, so mother states he has been wheezing and coughing. They saw their primary medical doctor. He was evaluated at the clinic. Given the breathing treatment and discharged home, was not having asthma, prescribed prednisone and an antibiotic. So in this way, students, the report is going to be made by the transcriptionist. Look, past medical history, asthma with his last admission. Also inclusive of frequent pneumonia. Okay, using the report. Then immunization up to date. Allergies denied, medications, this is the medication, whatever the medicines has been prescribed. Look, social history, lives at home here in the ED with the mother and there is no smoking in the home. No noted exposure, review of system documented. Then physical examination, vital signs, temperature was there, pulse, respiration, blood pressure and weight. Getting students, so this in this way what a transcriptionist has to make a medical report of that particular patient with the help of just having simple things, okay? Medical specialty, allergy, immunology, and sample name is asthma. So here, this is the task of the medical transcription. Now, again, there is a lot of, you know, demand of this medical transcriptionist also because there is a need, there is a demand that there should be somebody to translate these things in a very easy way that makes understand to the patient that what a patient is suffering, and even the doctors, they are having a handy report with them. Okay, so hope you've understood this. Now next one is your students, the fourth one is the data centers. Fourth is your data centers. Now, data centers. Data centers, students, where the information are stored, the databases, everything, and it's very large, large building, we can say, the organization, the institution, they are having the data centers. So, a data center is the department in an enterprise that houses and maintains backend IT systems and data stored mainframes. Backend IT system here, so student, is whatever is going behind the screen. Because students, whenever you are accessing, for example, you want to access any website. So what you just enter the website name, the URL, and you get that particular website like google.com. You are getting all those in the, on the front end, that is on your screen. But what is going on behind the screen, that is on the back, at the back end. You are not aware of that. So, data centers, all the information is stored in the data center. So there is always a data center, means there is a department in an enterprise that maintains the backend or houses the backend IT systems and data stores, mainframe, servers, databases. So a data center is a secure, we can say, the facilities that houses IT infrastructure such as network, computers and data storage. So computers here, we can see the server, storage system, switches and other components. So all these things, students, that makes your data center, and it is very important part of the IT system, because if there is no data center, who is going to store, who is going to maintain the backend IT system? So here is what a data center is, the it is the department in an enterprise. That maintains backend IT systems. Backend IT system means, students, backend means things which is the process which is going on behind the screen, behind your system. That means you are not aware what's going on, but you are just getting the front end. You are able to view the front end. That whatever the process has been done, it is displayed to you on your screen in the form of output, in the form of result. Okay, so and IT system and data stores. I'll show you the data center. Just see how big it is. Are all data centers. Just see how the things are kept. Everything, you just see number of the network here, the switches, the storage system, all the components, they are just together. Okay, so this is a data center. Look here. You just can't imagine how complicated as well it is if you have no idea that from where, which part of the system, which data server is having access to which. Means this very, this only the networking people will understand, those who have made it. Look, this is the data center. Okay, students, data center, you see this. So most of the organizations, they have their department of data center to maintain the backend system. Okay, here means, for example, any organization, they are having the thousands of machines and all the employees are there, they are working on that particular machines, but all the process is getting stored in the data center at the back end of the IT system. So here we can see the data center is a secure facilities that maintains or houses IT infrastructure such as network, computers and data storage. So computers here was student, the servers, storage systems, switches and other components, they are all are connected together. So it makes your data center. So hope you've understood this also, students. So here we have completed again two more IT enabled services. So in next lecture, inshallah, we are going to see three more services of IT enabled. Okay, so hope you've understood this. Again, I'm telling you, students, just practice more and more on OLE. You have your access to your OLE account using your ID and password. Your ID can be your email ID or your phone number, most probably your phone number. Okay, and if you are not able to have access to it, there is a contact number on the website. Please contact to that number and just try to have more and more practice of the question papers. So inshallah, you can do it very easily. If you know the terms, if you are well aware of the terms, you can crack the papers and you can have 100 on 100 as well. Okay, so inshallah, in next lecture we'll continue with the remaining technology services, that is information technology enabled services. Until then, take care. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.